When boat engine builder Mer Cruiser closed its Stillwater manufacturing plant in 2010, it hit the town of 47,000 pretty hard. Nearly 400 people lost their jobs, and the city lost almost $2 million in sales tax. So when Governor Mary Fallon and Oklahoma Commerce Secretary Dave Lopez, attending an international air show in Farnborough, England, announced that ASCO Incorporated, a Belgian-based aerospace manufacturer, is going to reopen the shuttered plant and create about 600 new jobs, they could probably hear the cheers from Stillwater all the way across the Atlantic. We were in Stillwater as that announcement was being made about new aerospace jobs coming in to the Sooner State.
There's 4 months on the job, and here we are.
It's one of those announcements state leaders love to make.
It is a thrill for me to be here.
600 new skilled aerospace jobs heading to Stillwater.
What is good for Stillwater is good for our entire state.
Aircraft manufacturer ASCO is just the latest aerospace company to move to Oklahoma, joining 1,200 others that already contribute more than $12.5 billion to the state's economy. Good news for Oklahoma, and great news for a city that's seen several manufacturers close their doors.
I think this is a defining, game-changing announcement for Stillwater. It not only from an economic standpoint, with the addition of jobs, but the type of jobs, but also on an emotional standpoint.
I think this is John Bartley is mayor of Stillwater.
I think it shows that that Stillwater has rebounded and has recovered. We lost jobs with the Mercury leaving, but we've reevaluated, and a focus on the aerospace. A new door is open, and we're taking advantage of it. And I can feel from the community how happy people are and the excitement behind it.
The Belgian-based company will hire up to 600 employees beginning in September. Its first manufacturing plant in the U.S.
This announcement could have happened absolutely anywhere. Anywhere. It's not by accident that it's in Stillwater.
Thanks in part to a list of state and federal tax incentives. Stillwater Chamber of Commerce CEO Lisa Navrakol.
So really just the incentives played a very key role for us. We were able to offer them the federal incentive of the new market tax credits,
as well as Oklahoma's Quality Jobs Program, which gives companies a payroll tax rebate for creating new jobs that pay above the state average. State Representative Cory Williams.
Well, they help us level the playing field with the rest of our competitors, which unfortunately, you know, it's a global marketplace, and certainly domestically, we're competing on a state-by-state basis. So our ability to attract businesses depends a lot on what we can do through economic incentive and tax. That's the one area that we can really control. And so I think in this situation and in other situations that we've been involved with, they play an incredible role.
So while the tax incentives may attract companies like ASCO to the state, for the long term, it's the training and learning laboratories like this that builds the workforce that keeps the companies here.
We're going to do it in a couple of phases.
Rebecca Easton is the business director at Meridian Technology Center.
We're going to expand our facilities a bit and then offer additional times of training. So that's the first phase. The second phase then will be to add some short-term machining specifically for the aerospace industry. Again, we'll offer evening programs, weekend programs, and then working together with ASCO, we're going to look to set up a training center there on site that we can do some additional training.
Work, Eastman says, will continue as the international aerospace company continues to grow in Stillwater.
I think the beauty of career tech. It doesn't end. Our technology center is here for a long-term partnership with any company, whether it's ASCO or any company coming into our district. We love to build that long-term relationship. And I think, quite honestly, that was one of the attractive things for ASCO, when we could tell a story that we were with Mercury Marine from the day they opened the door till the day they closed the door. And that's the relationship that we like to build with all the companies within our district, as do all technology centers across the state of Oklahoma. And I think that is just what makes the Oklahoma Career Tech System so unique, is that we are partners with industry. We love to find out what they've got going on, and we're going to tweak our curriculum to make sure we're getting them the skilled workforce that they need, not just to sustain their business, but to grow their business.
training for these new jobs could take from several weeks to a full year. But before that even happens, instructors at Meridian Tech will be traveling to Belgium to make sure they're teaching the skills the company needs. Just all in a day's work, according to the school superintendent, Doug Major.
We know already that a lot of the skill sets that ASCO is going to require of its employees, that we have training developed for that. But we also know that we're going to have to develop some new areas, and we're excited about that because we're continuing to change as processes change. And so we're confident that in our CNC machining, in our quality control, in our assembly programs, we're ready.
A fact not lost on state lawmakers.
To talk about career tech for a moment, significant economic impact and a huge recruiting tool for our state. I mean, to say that we can train your employees better than anybody, and if you happen to evolve your business or change your business or alter anything once you're here, we can quickly pick up the slack there and retrain your employees for anything that you want to do. Career tech was a huge, huge part of this announcement with ASCO and Stillwater. Significant.
Well, the average salary for our new jobs at ASCO will be right around $45,000 annually. The company says it will start interviewing as early as September and begin training shortly thereafter. Now, if you're interested or know someone that is, we have that toll-free number of the Oklahoma Employment Security Commission listed on our website, as well as a feature on the impact Oklahoma's Quality Jobs Program has on recruiting such companies here into the state. Just head to okrising.com and click on this week's Value Added.